Your thanks, Mr. Alvarez.
I'm sorry, I sidetracked this end of the exhibit, Your Honor. Are we ready to proceed to Mr. Alvarez?
I think we are.
Your Honor, I am under oath, so I'm going to proceed as such. On April 5th, 2013, Mr. Hamburg was appointed administrator by consent of Mrs. Kingery and I, as the court knows. On June 5th, 2013, Mrs. Kingery filed a claim in the sum of $16,626.06. I filed an objection to the claim shortly thereafter. On June 21st, 2013, I filed a claim for the funeral of my father in the sum of $16,626.06. Mrs. Kingery filed an objection in July. Thereafter, a letter from Mr. Spears, which is Plaintiff's Exhibit 15 of Friday 2, either one of them is the same exhibit, was sent. And in that letter, Mr. Spears states that to resolve those claims, he needs certain documentation. I produced the documentation which is required justifying that the bank account that I had with my father was a joint account. Therefore, the funds would survive. I would take the funds by being the surviving account holder. And Ms. Kingery did not. She refusing to produce the documentation, and it was arguments between written arguments or emails back and forward between Mr. Spears and Ms. Kingery, and she went ahead and filed several pleadings, as the court may know, challenging the request that have been made by Mrs. Spears in the letter. Then we went to state court on August 18, 2014, in a state court case that we had. And on that day, we entered into a settlement agreement, which is F1. In that settlement agreement, Your Honor, in paragraph of the settlement agreement, which states the plaintiff and the defendant shall share equally the proceeds of the estate property contained within the estate of Federico Alvarez and Graciela Alvarez, less any expenses awarded by the administrator. The state court does not have the states, does not deal with the states. In that paragraph, it was unambiguous, it was clear, it was not pertinent to the state court at all. That paragraph basically says the claims and the objections that the parties have in the state court are resolved, are settled. And it's up to the administrator. So whatever the administrator had proposed before in that letter, which is a proposal by the administrator indicating how the claims should be resolved by the production of the documents, I left to the administrator. Whatever the administrator said in the letter is considered to be is resolved by that paragraph. Relying on that letter, it grants the administrator the total discretion subject to the court order, to the probate court, and under his fiduciary duties to proceed. It gives the green light to the administrator so that he can prepare the final taxation, tax returns, file the returns, the publications, and close estates. That should have been it. Nothing else should have gone forward. The case was resolved, Your Honor. It was settled. Even though there was such a settlement, she disregarded the settlement and continued going forward, filing pleadings, challenging the claim that I had that supposedly had been resolved, and the administrator had agreed that upon production of the bank statements, it should be a payable claim, in which I had done it. And it went on and on and on through the, even until the last hearing, without a legal basis. It had not a legal basis to go on. The estate should have been resolved during said year. In the year 2014, during August 2014, it could have been the conclusion. But she went ahead and continued, and the administrator, as well as the attorney for the administrator, with much justification, they had to keep billing the state. And I submit to the court that that is something that the state should not be responsible for. That the case has been settled, and we agreed that the administrator and obviously the attorney could go ahead from that point forward and close it. More than 65 filings occurred since that day. As Mr. Spears had testified before, it was an explosion. She went out of control, and the estate, the administrator, and the attorney kept billing the estate, and it is my contention that she should be responsible for all the attorney fees from that point forward, as well as the administrative fees. I have reviewed the statements from both Mr. Spears and Mr. Hamburg, and I have noticed that from that point forward, in excess of 80% of the activity in the accounts, the charges, Your Honor, have been answering and responding to Mrs. Ingrid's filings and emails and discussions pertaining to Mrs. Ingrid. I have filed with the court a document which I had named Heir Fredy M. Alvarez Response to Administrator's Petition for Settlement of Account Approval of Final Distribution Plan on April 1st, 2016. In said document, I have petitioned or asked the court to assess attorney fees, not only for that, but also for her failure to appear and pretty much boycott the closing of the house, blackmailing the administrator if she would not receive a satisfaction to the claim that she had filed when the administrator had no funds in his possession to pay her. And he dedicated a substantial amount of time there as well before Mr. Spears was employed. And Your Honor, I have cited OCGA 9-11-68 and OCGA 13-6-11. And those statutes provide for bad faith and stubborn litigation, just litigation in bad faith. And it is my contention that the state should not be responsible, but she should be responsible for those things. And Your Honor, and to conclude, it's not only I have personal knowledge that she has filed a report in order to get her way with what she wanted to get, a report with the State Bar of Georgia against Mr. Hamburg. I know that she has filed with the Judicial Commission a complaint against Your Honor, and she tried to get me arrested and file a report with the State Bar against me. She has been represented by 8 attorneys since this dispute commenced. And so it's not an excuse that she did not know what she was doing. She, whether the attorneys stayed with her or not, is something that is between her and the attorneys, but I'm confident that she has acted knowingly, intentionally, and she has well executed her actions and her fight before this court.
Thank you. Do you wish to cross-examine Mr. Alvarez, or either of you?
I have some great questions, Judge.
Okay.
Good afternoon, Mr. Alvarez.
Good afternoon.
You and I just met today.
Yes, sir.
You thought representing your sister in this case. Ms. Chandler. As part of your testimony to the judge just a few minutes ago, you made the assertion that more than 80% of the fees for the administrator and the counsel to the administrator were attributable to Ms. Kinger. You ever make that statement?
I made that statement, and that has been since August 14, 2018, when the settlement was reached.
I understand. Now, have you presented a document, entered into evidence, showing the math of how you came to 80%, or is that a speculation that you're making?
That is based on my review of this statement filed by Mr. Hamburg and the statement filed by Mr. Spears. They are exhibits submitted to the court.
There's no exhibit that matches your 80% assertion, though. That's the point I want to bring to the court. Is that true?
That is true.
Yes. All right. The part of the reason that we're here today is that you have asked the court to cast the cost of the attorney's fees or part of the attorney's fees against your sister. Isn't that true?
That is correct.
Okay.
It has been based on what I have seen in my experience as an attorney for 36 years, is a obvious case of abusive litigation.
Now, it's a true statement that if I had to point to the two people in this room who are responsible for the litigation today, one finger's pointed at you, one finger's pointed at her. It's both of you, isn't it?
For the litigation today, no.
Are you withdrawing your claim against her for a disproportionate share of the estate?
I have no claim against her for this proposal of the claim against the state. My claim is the prayers on one of my pleadings.
So you still maintain that claim? Is that your testimony?
It's in the prayer.
Okay, I don't want to argue with you about it. Now, you also made the assertion during your statement to the judge that Ms. Kingery boycotted the real estate closing. That's your word, isn't it, boycott?
It's my word, but it has been testimony from both Mr. Spears and Mr. Hamburg that she sent emails directly into her attorney that she was not paid in advance the claims that she had against the state, she would not attend the closing.
There are two facts that are true about the closing. She was present, and she was not paid anything from the closing proceeds. Those are two facts. Is that correct?
Those are two correct facts, but before she attended the closing, Mr. Hamburg had to send letters to her, and to her attorney, and those are the exhibits that the court has now, indicating that if she didn't go up here, the estate was going to be sued by the potential buyer based on breach of contract, and also it would be all the damages not only to the state but to herself and to myself again now as well.
Mr. Alvarez, do you know who the purchaser of the real estate is?
I do not know who the purchaser of the real estate is. I know only what I have seen in the documents that the administrator has provided me.
Is it a true and factual statement that you have no relationship with the buyer or anyone who has an interest in that property or a right to purchase that property?
That is true and correct.
Thank you. Mr. Spears?
One quick question. Well, maybe two. Is there any truth to the allegation that you and Walt Hamburg somehow colluded with you to harm your sister in this estate?
Absolutely not.
Second question, and last, is I haven't heard that you have objected to our petitions for fees or for compensation. Is that correct? You're not objecting to them?
I am not objecting. I think you have done an outstanding job based on what you had to work with.
Thank you. No further questions, Your Honor.
Step down, sir.
Thank you. You really have been close to the edge.
Do we have anything else to talk about other than reconvening on Monday? 4 o'clock.